Hi everyone, today I present solar panels wiring to one inverter and the grid in a self-consumption installation. It's something which is quite simple to do by yourself. So don't hesitate, and now let's go.
The first characteristic which is important is what we called the voltage in open circuit, which in our case is around 40 volt. It's a maximum voltage a panel can provide. The second characteristic, which is very important also, is what we call the short circuit current. In our case, it's 11 amps. It's a maximum current such a panel can provide. Just one point, don't try to do that test because you can maybe damage your panel. Now we will address the subject of the characteristic of the panel when we have an electrical load connected to it, in order to define which is the maximum power this panel can provide. In our case here, we have a voltage at the output of the panel around 38 volt, a current of 10 amps. You know that the power, the total power, is the product of the current multiplied by the tension. So we have here a maximum power around 380 watt, which is the maximum this panel can provide. Then we address the subject of 6 volt photovoltaic panels wiring in parallel. That means we connect the negative outputs together, the positive outputs of the panel, the panels together, and so we obtain a voltage in open circuit for this group or string of panels about 40 volts. It's exactly the same as one panel, as the panels are connected in parallel. And for a short circuit current, as they are in parallel, we have to multiply by 6, so we have 6 times 11 amps, so 66 amps. This is the maximum current this string of panels can provide. So the maximum power in that case is 6 times 380 watts, so 2280 watts. But this is a system which is not very interesting, as it provides a lot current, which is very, very important and requires very thick cables, wiring. So it's not the best solution, and we have also some secondary effect we will detail later. Let's address another way to interconnect 6 panels is to use 6 micro-inverters. 6 independent micro-inverters which converts a DC current to AC current, and they are just connected as the outputs on the AC side. So it's an interesting configuration we'll address later in an other video. Now we will see the configuration where we have the same 6 panels but wired in serial. So we connect the negative for one panel to the positive of the other, and we follow like that. So we have the 6 panels connected together, and we have a voltage in open circuit of 6 times 40 volts. So 6 times the voltage in open circuit for one panel, which is in that case around 240 volts. The short circuit current is the same as for one panel, as the panels are connected in serial, so 11 amps. And the maximum power is 6 times 380 watts, so 2280 watts, as before. This is a very interesting configuration. We will address now more in detail. The only drawback is if one panel, for example, is masked by a tree or the house or building, so it can impact all the production of all the 5 other panels. Most of the times, all these panels are connected together using what we call MC4 connectors. Now, We'll address more in detail the DC side, the direct current side, as when we have all these panels connected in serial, we need at least a switch to be able to switch off this group of panels, at least during maintenance or installation. So it's why we have a switch, a DC switch here. And we have also, as required by some legislation in some countries, we have a lightning protection on the DC side. Now we address the characteristic of the inverter. Here we have a system which is able to manage 2.5 kilowatts on the input side, so it's acceptable as we can provide a maximum of 2.3 watts roughly with our panels. Maximum input voltage of 500 volts, this is also acceptable. A minimum voltage of 50 volts. The minimum voltage corresponds to the voltage when the system starts to convert DC to AC. Maximum input current of 30 amps, so we have a maximum of 11 amps in short circuit. It's acceptable in our situation. Now we address how much power so string of panels can provide. We have seen that when you are in short circuits, no voltage, we have a maximum current of 11 amps. When we have no current consumed but we are in open circuits, we have here a maximum voltage of about 240 volts, we have seen. But in both cases, we have no power produced. You know, the power is a product of tension multiplied by current. In this case, we have no tension, maximum of current. In this case, maximum of voltage, no current. So we produce no power with our group of panels. But somewhere in the middle, we have maximum of power. Here, in our case, is around 228 volts, which correspond to 6 times 38 volts we have seen for the best voltage for one panel alone, and 10 amps. So this is a response curve of our group of panels. And the first job of the inverter is to find this point where we can extract the maximum of power. It's what we call the maximum power point tracking. The inverter must find the position of this point. Early in the morning, when we have not sun shining importantly, this curve is more or less pushed to the left and to the bottom, this yellow curve. So we have a maximum power which is lower. But the inverter all the time trying to find where is the best point in on this yellow curve. Another way to represent this power output versus voltage here is what we have here. The voltage here on this axis, the power on this axis, and when we start at low voltage, we have a low power, but this increase up to the maximum here, and then when the voltage at the output of the group increase again, as the current decreases, the power will decrease, and we have such curves. It's another way to represent what we call the maximum power point tracking. The second job for the inverter is to generate a 230 volts. But these 230 volts must work in Europe at 50 Hertz. We have to generate an alternative current around 50 Hertz, so with a period of one sinusoidal signal of 20 milliseconds. So the job is to synchronize the output of the inverter with the signal coming from the public grid. If you cannot cover the complete consumption of energy in your house, part of the energy is coming from the public grid and part of the energy coming from your inverter. So both must be perfectly synchronized in frequency. So around 50 Hertz, and also synchronize in phase. So when we have the maximum on the public grid, we need also the maximum at the output of the inverter. So this is the second job of the inverter, is to synchronize perfectly the output signals with the public grid. We need also to protect the AC output, some circuit breakers, so differential circuit breaker here in our case, and also main circuit breaker, to be able to switch off the complete system, just at least for maintenance. And we have also lightning protection on the AC side. This is a practical installation where we have the inverter here, the DC signal arriving here, and the DC protection box located here, and so the DC signal arrive, pass through the protection box, go to the inverter, and then the AC signal goes to AC protection box before joining the electrical panel in a house. One point also which is very important is that we have to connect all the elements by an earthing line. We have to connect to the earth all metallical part of the panels for the DC protection, the inverter, the lightning protection on the AC side, and so everything is connected to the earth, and we can have a circuit breaker on your in-house electrical panel, which most of the time is far away from the installation of the panels and the inverter. Now we will address the subject of the wiring of two times six panels, so of two group or two strings of panels, with two MPPT, maximum power point tracker. Here we have one group of six, which enter in an inverter, which has two inputs, two MPPT inputs, one for one group of panels and one for the second group of panels. This is very interesting in case, for example, you have panels on the east side of your house and other panels on the west side of your house. When you have two group of panels, and one solution is to put them in parallel. But this is a risky solution, because if, for example, you have the sun on the east side and low sun on the west side, you have a voltage which is higher on the this group than on the west side group. And so you will inject some energy from the east side inside the west side, and this create a hotspot, and you have a risk of fire. So this is not installation recommended configuration. Right. Sometimes we put in parallel the panels, one, two, three panels, if they are located on the same side. So this is not a recommended configuration. To install a protection against this risk of hotspots, we can put diodes to isolate the east side from the west side. The current coming out from the east side will never go to the west, and reverse, the west will never go to the east. In that configuration, you can work only with one MPPT. It's an interesting configuration also, but all the time your MPPT will cover perfectly the group which produce a lot of power, and the group which is produced less will not provide energy, and this is not the best configuration if you want to maximize your production of energy. On my website you will find all details. It's my call sign, my amateur ham radio call sign, htpfs f180b.fr. In the section Home Automation, you will find details and this video. And you find also details, for example, on the system to measure power at the input of your house in order to see if you have the power you consume. And in case of overproduction coming from your panels, you can measure this overproduction and take some decision to inject or to consume, to start consumption, for example, to switch on your water heater to consume your overproduction.
Now, this is the end of this presentation. Don't hesitate to go on https f180b.fr in the section Home Automation to have further information on this subject. Thank you for watching me, and don't forget to subscribe on my channel.